This is the story of La Hormiguita, written by Joe Hayes and performed by myself, Felicia Sanchez Garbiso. La Hormiguita waited all winter long in her underground home because the ground was covered with nothing but snow. But no sooner did the snow start to melt, La Hormiguita grabbed her mama and she ran to the door and she looked outside the window and she said, "Mira, mama, mira! The grass is green, the snow is melting. Can I go outside and play, please?" And her mama looked down at her and said, "No, mijita, don't you see those big dark clouds? Can't you feel how cold it is? I don't want you going outside to play. Do you hear me?" "Fine," said La Hormiguita. But while La Hormiguita's mama was busy in the house, she snuck outside to play anyway. She had a blast. She went up every blade of grass. She went upside down on branches and trees. La Hormiguita was having so much fun. She didn't realize she was pretty far from home, and she began to feel cold. "Mama was right. I better get going home." So as La Hormiguita started to crawl off the branch, she noticed something coming from the sky that she had never seen before. She got to the bottom of the tree all the way to the ground, and she looked up at, in amazement, at snow. La Hormiguita, the little ant, had never seen snow before. She stood there looking at the quiet snow falling down. She stood there looking in amazement like this. La Hormiguita was so busy looking at the snowflake floating all the way down. She didn't realize that one snowflake came all the way down and it froze her foot to the ground. When she went to walk away, she couldn't move. Her foot was stuck. She looked down at the snow and she told the snow, "Snow, let go of my foot so I could go home." "Nieve, nieve, suelta mi patita porque vaya a mi casita." And you know what the snow did? The snow looked up and said, "No quiero, I don't want to." "What do you mean you don't want to? Let go of my foot so I could go home." The snow wouldn't listen to her, so La Hormiguita had to think fast. "What about the sun? What if I ask the sun to melt the snow? Then the snow will listen." So she called out to the sun and she told the sun to melt the snow. She said, "Sol, sol, derrite nieve, nieve, suelta mi patita para que vaya a mi casita." And the sun looked down and said, "No quiero, I don't want to." Well, La Hormiguita didn't know what to do. She thought and thought and thought, maybe a cloud. Maybe if she told the cloud to cover the sun would listen and melt the snow. So she called out to the cloud and told the cloud to cover the sun. She said, "Nube, nube, tapa sol, sol, derrite nieve, nieve, suelta mi patita para que vaya mi casita." And the cloud looked down on Hormiguita and said, "No quiero, I don't want to." Well, the cloud wouldn't listen, and the sun wouldn't listen, and the snow wouldn't listen. She didn't know who could help her unless there was this huge gust of wind. The wind! She could ask the wind. So she called out to the wind, and she told the wind to blow away the cloud. Viento, viento, desbarata nube, nube, tapa sol, sol, derrite nieve, nieve. Suelta mi patito para que vaya mi casita. And the wind called out and said, La Hormiguita was so frustrated and she was getting cold. The wind wouldn't listen to her. She didn't know what to do, except maybe if she told a wall to block the wind. Far in the distance, she could see a building with a nice strong wall. So she called out to the wall and she told the wall to block the wind. She said, "Pared, pared, ataja viento. Viento, desbarata nube, nube tapa sol, sol derrite nieve, nieve. Suelta mi patita para que vaya mi casita." And the wall stood there as stiff as could be and said, "No quiero. Oh, La Hormiguita was getting so cold and she didn't know what to do. She didn't know what would make the wall listen to her. Oh, wait. I know. What about those little creatures who like to gnaw holes through the wall? Do you know what they are? Yes, a mouse. She called out to the mouse and she told the mouse to gnaw holes through the wall. Then the wall would listen. So she told the mouse, Raton, negrejereya pare, pare rataja viento, viento desparata nube, nube tapa sol, sol derrite nieve, nieve, salta mi patita pa que vaya mi casita. And that little raton, you know what he said? He looked up at la hormiguita and said, no quiero hormiguita, I don't want to. La hormiguita didn't know what to do if that little mouse didn't listen to her. Do you know anything that likes to chase mice? And La hormiguita was thinking and thinking. Yes, a cat. So she called out to the cat far in the distance and she told the cat to chase the mouse. Gato, gato, recoge ratón. Ratón, agujereo pared. Pared ataja viento. Viento desparata nube. Nube tapa sol. Sol derrite nieve. Nieve, por favor. Suelta mi patita para que vaya a mi casita. And the gato called out and said, no quiero, hormiguita. The cat didn't want to help her either. Well, I only know one thing that likes to chase cats. A dog. And there was a lazy dog sleeping on the porch way in the distance. And so she called out to that dog and she told the dog to chase the cat. Perro, perro, persigue gato. Gato, recoge ratón. Ratón, agujereo pared. Pared ataja viento. Viento desparata nube. Nube tapa sol. Sol derrite nieve. Nieve. Por favor, suelta mi patita para que vaya a mi casita. And that lazy dog, you know what he did? He barely opened one eye and said, no quiero. La hormiguita didn't know what to do. She was freezing. She wasn't supposed to be outside. And she was so cold and no one would help her. I don't know what would make that dog listen, she thought. And then she remembered, wait. What are those little things that live on the dog and make them itch and they bite the dog? Fleas! Yes. Maybe she could call out to the flea and tell the flea to bite the dog. And then he would listen. So she made one last plea to the flea. She said, pulga! Pica perro! Perro persigue gato! Gato recoge ratón! Ratón agujereo pared! Pared ataja viento! Viento desparata nube! Nube tapa sol! Sol derrite nieve! Nieve! Suelta mi patita porque vaya mi casita! And you know what? Well, the flea is the cousin to the ant. And when she heard her prima crying for help, she said, si, como no? Why not? So she bit the dog. And the dog said, okay. So he started chasing the cat. And that gato started chasing that little mouse. And that mouse started gnawing holes through the wall because that gato was coming. The wall blocked the wind. The wind blew away the cloud. The cloud covered the sun. The sun melted the snow. And the snow let go of La Hormiguita's foot. Oh, and La Hormiguita ran home as fast as her little legs could carry her. And from then on, La Hormiguita waited until it was springtime and she could go outside and play. And that's the story of La Hormiguita.